What's up, everybody? Welcome back to Figure It Out, Out of the Basement's Black Series talk show. I'm Nate, joined with Justin.
What's up, guys?
And today, we've actually got some news to discuss.
We have some news.
We finally got a certain helmet revealed. There's also going to be a live stream soon, so we're going to talk about what we would like to see, our predictions for this coming live stream.
Right.
And we also have a new sort of event thing where there's going to be reveals every week, like bring home the bounty.
Right.
Before we get into that, though, don't forget to leave a like and subscribe if you are new. We're always talking about Black Series news and reviews here on the channel.
Mm-hmm. Well, we do have a new stream coming up. It is the Pulse Premium 1027 fan stream.
Well, that's a mouthful.
That's going to be October 27th, 5 p.m. Eastern Time. It's also their address, 1027, so that's why they chose October 27th.
I see.
So you can only watch the stream if you're a Hasbro Pulse Premium member.
So it looks like we won't be watching it, but I'm sure we'll be able to find out all the reveals and all the details of all the stuff that we need to.
Right.
Last year, there were Black Series reveals during this event, and we saw Echo, Omega, the Jetta Patrol Stormtrooper, and Bib Fortuna.
Yeah, pretty solid lineup. Actually, some really exciting figures. I kind of have high hopes this time around, although for mainline, we pretty much know everything that's coming. Like, those four figures were all mainline, and we know, like, Wave 35, even a nice chunk of Wave 36, with all the new Andor stuff that kind of answered a lot of those mystery figures. So we have some predictions, and it's almost kind of like a predictions slash rumored figures and, like, just a pipeline rundown to see what we could see in hand photos of from this event.
I think we have decent potential to maybe see some Lucasfilm publishing figures like Mike or Mara Jade.
Yeah.
Maybe not necessarily part of the publishing line, but Starkiller or Jesse.
Yeah, Jesse is rumored. I don't think they've actually officially pipelined him, though. But Starkiller hasn't been pipelined either, but these are rumors from Yak Face, and that's pretty reliable.
Yeah.
I'd be down to see any of these. So those are some of the more rumored figures, but we also have pipeline figures. Like, we still have some 40th Return of the Jedi stuff to see.
Yeah.
The wave after the one that they did reveal, and the Boba Fett and Endor Rebel Soldier. We have seen some in-hand shots of the Boba Fett, so I'd be more interested in seeing the Endor Rebel Soldier, especially because it's going to be deluxe.
Yeah.
So I would like to see how they justify that.
Let's hope for swappable faces like the Hoth Rebel Soldier.
Yes.
And maybe some swappable armor pieces, since, you know, a lot of the Endor troopers kind of have like little different bits and straps and pouches and stuff.
Yeah, I could see that. Or it could be something pipelined kind of, you know, a few months back, such as the Ki-Adi Mundi, Mando with the Darksaber, or Black Chrysanthemum. I would be fine seeing either of those three. Those three are hopefully going to be absolute bangers. But it also could be the Hasbro PulseCon 2022 pipeline stuff. A lot of stuff has been pipelined lately. We have the Pike Soldier, Cad Bane, the Tusken Chieftain, R2, the Luke, the Vader.
We still haven't seen the KOTOR figures, Bastila, or Darth Malak as well.
True, I'd be down for either of those as well, especially if they're going to be the art, which the photos they used were like the models from the original game.
Yeah.
So please do those.
I think based on what Eric said in Luke Nissa's interview with him, I think it's pretty safe to say that the KOTOR figures will most likely be the classic costumes.
Thank goodness.
Yeah, it would be great to see some of these. We've been waiting to see them for a while. A couple events have come and gone where I've kind of been like, you know, where's something like Ki-Adi Mundi?
They just keep pipelining
without
revealing, I feel like. Because even that was a previous event with the Black Chrysanthemum, Din Djarin, and the Ki-Adi Mundi. And then we went another event and they just pipelined more stuff.
Right. This pipe is getting pretty long. Gonna have to call the Pipe Fitters Union soon enough.
Call up my brother. Shout out to Jason. And not this guy.
Yeah, hopefully we do get to see some stuff like that. I think we will. I think it's pretty much about time that they start revealing the next wave of mainline figures. Even though we know what they are, it'll still be cool to actually see something, whether it's a render or whether it's the actual figure in hand. Mm-hmm. Either way would be pretty cool in my book. I'm just down to see some new figures, especially some new Jedi.
Let's get that Starkiller.
Today, the day we're filming, Tuesday, also marked a brand new weekly event called Bring Home the Galaxy, which is going to be a weekly thing on StarWars.com where merchandise is revealed. It's not going to always necessarily be Black Series or Vintage Collection or even figures in general.
It could be like Crocs.
All right. Clothes, yeah. Hats, jackets, all sorts of different stuff.
They did it before with Bring Home the Bounty, which I think that was more so like Book of Boba Fett or Mando related, or they did Mando Mondays and Obi-Wan Wednesdays, and now it's Bring Home the Galaxy, Nate.
Yeah, and today we did get a brand new wave of retro figures, which is cool for people who like the retro stuff. But the main attraction of today's news is we finally got to see the brand new helmet, which is the Phase 2 Clone Trooper. It's real, Justin.
It is real, and we finally got to see it, and there's controversy with it.
Of course.
And I'm going to be fair here. Mm-hmm. I'm going to be fair to both sides of the coin on this one. I think it looks a little off.
Yeah, initial reaction when I first saw it, I went, oh, that looks odd.
Because it's Phase 2 Clone Trooper, and it is in a Clone Wars box, but from what I can tell, I am not one of those, like, Kaminoan customs. I am not one of those people that, like, get out the magnifying glass. I'm a detail-oriented person, but I'm not that... I don't go that hard. So, as far as what I can tell, it looks like it's a live-action helmet sculpt.
Mm-hmm.
But the visor, like, the biggest thing is the visor. It looks like the animated visors.
Thankfully, we have a black line, though.
We do have, thank goodness, we have a black line. It looks good, but again, it just did look a little off at first. And to get the negatives right out of the way, I do find it kind of frustrating that they can't make up their minds of whether they want a live-action theatrical Clone Trooper, because they can't even decide that with the actual figures, mm-hmm. or do they want the animated style. They're always doing these, like, hybrids that are a little bit of theatrical and a little bit of animated. I would like them, for consistency's sake, to just go live action or go animated. In the Black Series, 99% of the time, we go live action, even if it's an animated character.
Mm-hmm.
So in that regard, I do kind of find it frustrating that this is a hybrid of animated and live action, but yeah. It still looks good.
Like I was saying, at first I definitely thought it was odd to see, but the more I looked at it and saw it in the other angles that the promotional pictures have, I really don't think it does look all that bad. I think it looks pretty decent in my opinion. Yeah, I do agree though with you. It is frustrating that they can't really pick a lane to stay in, but still I think it looks close enough. It's still a Clone Trooper Phase 2. Like, when I look at it, I don't think it's something else.
Of course.
And I think what it's really going to come down to is the price of this, because if you've ever looked into getting a Clone Trooper helmet, even some of the cheapest ones, which are just like 3D printed, will still run you a couple hundred dollars. And there's even more official products out there. Denuo Novo, that it's like a company that's owned by NECA, but they make really expensive Star Wars prop replicas.
Okay, yeah, I saw, because they were sending some comparison pics in our Discord, so I'm going to throw up those images here of the, Denuo Novo. It's a $650 Phase 2 Clone Trooper helmet, and when you look at them side by side, for this one, which I'm assuming is going to be around $131.99,
mm-hmm.
versus a $650 item, they don't look that far off.
Yeah, you could definitely tell there's a difference between the two. And of course, the more high-end one looks a lot more accurate.
Oh, yes.
As it should, as you're paying a premium price for that. Not that around $131 isn't also a premium price.
It is.
But in terms of trying to actually buy a Clone Trooper helmet in this day and age, the Hasbro option is most likely going to be the most affordable route. And thankfully, it is a plain white helmet, so this also opens the door for endless amounts of customization.
Yes, that is true.
Obviously, they're going to do their own repaints. I'm pretty sure there's already a 501st one, like, basically confirmed.
I would imagine. I mean, it's the most popular clone legion. I gotta think a 501st is coming.
But if you're into customizing, now you're gonna have a pretty affordable, decent looking helmet to just go crazy on and actually be able to, you know, paint it in different ranks if you so choose.
Yeah. I am kind of conflicted on comparing it to the $650 helmet because in as far as figures go, that makes sense. Like comparing Black Series to Hot Toys, I find that dumb.
Mm-hmm.
So it's almost a similar comparison with this, but I feel like the Stormtrooper helmet is accurate, so...
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, the right. Stormtrooper helmet that I have looks accurate to the films and the source material. This one, being the hybrid, I feel like that's just going to sort of annoy me, but I still like it, and obviously, I'm all in on a Phase 2 clone, but I do understand the people who are going to be upset over this one in particular, because I do wish they would just make up their minds.
Definitely. And we even see this with the figures that are currently coming out that are all Clone Wars related, where they're sometimes it's they've got the animated look with the black stripe. Sometimes it's animated, no black stripe. Sometimes they re-release the old clone body.
Yeah, that's sometimes theatrical. They do these hybrid, like, Bly legs, new clone body, upper torso, and arms.
Yeah. So it's really... honestly not surprising that this happened because we've seen it with the figures themselves. Yeah. But yes, it is still ultimately frustrating. However, I do think that, you know, the price is going to be right on this for most people. And again, just it being plain white, the customization options are going to be endless. So Justin, are you actually thinking about picking this helmet up?
I will pick it up. For sure. I'm still a fan of the animated look.
Yeah,
me even too. Though this is a hybrid. And I know it's more than just the visor. I saw some comments with like the circle on the back and the cheeks and how angular it is and everything.
Right.
It's still a Phase 2 Clone Trooper to me. And as a collector of the Black Series, I have the Stormtrooper helmet. And I've been saying for years now, if they ever do a Phase 2 Clone Trooper, that'll be like my second helmet that I get. Because we're not that big into the roleplay items here at Out of the Basement. I got the Stormtrooper helmet. You have prototype Boba.
Yep.
I have Mace and Darth Vader Force Effects lightsaber and the Darksaber Elite lightsaber.
True.
Thank you, Grandma Helen. And the Phase 2 Clone Trooper, that's going to edge out the roleplay items for me. Although, maybe wait for a 501st.
Yeah, I'm kind of conflicted on whether or not I want to go straight for the plain Phase 2 Clone Trooper helmet. I do want a Phase 2 Clone Trooper helmet, but yeah, I kind of feel like maybe wait it out for one of the more Legion specific repaints. Like, I would absolutely love a Coruscant Guard version.
Yes.
Or maybe even something like a 332nd Ahsoka clone.
Yeah, or maybe someone out there customizes a Max Rebo Legion Clone Trooper and we can put it right here.
Yeah.
Until the end of time. The possibilities are endless.
And the last little bit of news that I wanted to just sprinkle in here right before we go is we finally got a price on an upcoming rumored TVC vehicle set. So for the 40th anniversary of Return of the Jedi, we will be getting a Scout Trooper and Speeder Bike set for the Vintage Collection. And the price was revealed today at a staggering $44.99.
That's more than the Black Series when it first came out. I mean, adjust for inflation and all that.
Right.
You know.
I mean, even a couple years ago, we did get the Mandalorian set, which was $50. So this is a little bit of a stinger, and it's just kind of getting to the point where decisions are going to have to be made. And I just wanted to talk about it just because I saw the price and I was like, I almost can't believe it. For one figure and one tiny 3¾-inch bike, this is what we've gone to.
Yeah, I mean, there was a little Hasbro thing today that we're recording about they're acknowledging in relation to their stock price, but they acknowledged the pushback to higher prices.
Yeah.
And then that price got revealed today. Yeah. I was like,
Right. I think that this definitely is crossing into a threshold where, yeah, even a lot of people like myself who are really into TVC, especially Return of the Jedi TVC stuff, that's like my bread and butter right now. Even I'm like, ooh, I don't know if I'm going to be able to swing that for something so small. So, yeah, I just wanted to sprinkle that in there because it looks like there's no end in sight to the price hikes.
Yeah, we should make an episode of Figured Out. Are we getting priced out of the Black Series? But, like, answer it genuinely.
Yeah, I definitely want to discuss it further, and I think it deserves its own episode because it is kind of a tricky situation and something that has really only started to recently affect everyone within this past year or so.
Right.
But other than that, that is all we have for you on this week's episode of Figure It Out. If you enjoyed it, don't forget to leave a like, subscribe if you are new. We're always talking about Star Wars The Black Series here on the channel. If you'd like to support us in a more direct manner, we do offer a channel membership for 99 cents a month. You get access to a custom Clone Trooper name badge and custom emojis that you can use on our videos and in our live streams, which are every single Sunday at 1 p.m. Central Time. We do also have a small collection of merch. There are links for everything down in the description of this video. Justin, what else should they join? Join Discord, court.
Join that Discord, of course. Great conversations going on in there every single darn day.
Special shout out and big thank you to our current channel members. Your continued support is truly appreciated. And thank you to everyone else out there for simply watching, liking, subscribing, and sharing our videos with all your Star Wars figure loving friends. I'm Nate, join with Justin.
See you guys later.
And we will see you next time on Out of the Basement.